Hello.
Good morning. Welcome back to Space Engineers on the Xbox One. Today's trip into Space Engineers is something that I saw somebody ask about, which is how to make a very basic searchlight rig for the top of a base. It's just a simple rotating searchlight using a rotor, and I wanted to talk a little bit about rotors on the basic level. So, we need a searchlight. We're going to make one, starting with a few armor blocks like this, maybe one more. Then you want to put a rotor on this one. It's going to be our rotational rotor. Now, when you're placing rotors, I always suggest rotating the rotor until zero faces you, so you know where zero is. It's not so important on a rotor like this one that's going to rotate just round and round. And atop this rotor, we want another block. And onto this, we're going to place another rotor. And this rotor is going to be facing outwards like this. And again, we want zero in front of us, so we know exactly where zero is. We know positive speed on a rotor will take it towards 45, and negative will take it round the opposite way. And onto this rotor, we want to build a spotlight, which we will rotate so it's facing this way. So now you've got your basic rig. That is all you need to make a rotating spotlight. And what you can do is you can pop a control panel onto this little rig as well, so we can manipulate it. And if you've been following my other tutorials, you'll be able to know the controls as we're going through. Pressing X on the control panel will open it up. And what you're looking for is two rotors. One is on a subgrid, and one is on the grid you're looking at. The one that we're looking at is the one that we are going to have as our rotational rotor. This one will spin our rig round slowly. I suggest a velocity of about 1 RPM, and we'll deal with that in a minute. What we want, though, is, and we don't even need to look actually at the rotor in world to do this, because we know that we placed the rotor at zero. So if we move up to the coloured rotor, which is the one that's on the subgrid, that's the one that will allow us to position the light. Now, you can see share inertia tensor. We don't need that because we're not building a drill or anything like that that can move in such a way that it would need all the connections stiffening, or the masses of connected grids to be equalized. Nor do we want rotor lock yet. So what we want to do is we want to very carefully hold down the right bumper and tap right on the D-pad, and you'll now see the angle of the rotor is changing. And that's why I said we don't even need to look. So while it's changing, move to rotor lock and wait. Now, this will take a little, but I suggest doing it at 20 so you're not left. And we want about a 35 to 40 degree angle based on where we are. So when it gets to about 40 degrees, press rotor lock. Now, that will stop the rotor from moving. Then you can go back to your velocity, hold down the right bumper, tap left on the D-pad, and each time you hold down the right bumper, you're going to speed or slow down something by 20. So if you go right, 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 you'll get to 1 RPM. So left, 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 back to zero. And that's a really quick way of getting speeds that you want with rotors and other things. We don't need to worry about the lower and the upper limit on a rotor, but to give you an idea of what they do, the lower limit is can be set to a minus on a rotor, say minus 311, the upper limit can be set to 347, then the rotor will only move between those two settings. It won't go any further, it won't go past minus 311, and it won't go above 347. If you've got it on unlimited, both lower and upper, that means it will spin constantly when power and velocity is applied to it. Your rotor displacement is how far the rotor head is away from the rotor itself, which is useful for closing gaps when you're making things like doors and other things like that. So we've got all that set. Now all we need to do is nip across to the other rotor, and with this one what we want is to look at its speed, its velocity, and we want to bring that up to about 1 RPM, and that will spin our light. So if we come out, you'll notice though it's going the wrong way. That's not a problem. Back into the control panel, back down to the rotor. And all you need to do is hit A on reverse. That will send your light rig rotating round again. And if you need a faster rotation, you can always set the velocity to 2. And say I prefer about 1 revolution a minute. To give you an idea of what it looks like, if you hold down the right bumper, press Y. Then you can change your time of day offset. Get it nice and dark. There you go. That is a very simple rotating base light. And if you find the angle is too steep or too shallow, you can use the control panel to change that rotor there. If you look, that's why I had it placed to 0. It's at 45 degrees exactly. Maybe you want it shallower, so it comes out over here. And that's really all there is to that little light rig. To give you an idea of the kind of things you can do with rotors, if we nip over here to my little headquarters, past the Century Eagle, down on the floor, you can see I've created a rotor-based garage door using the upper and lower limit on the rotor and blast door blocks, because they don't have collision, if you look, between other blocks, so you can use those to seal a gap. Now those aren't airtight though, so if you try to do that in a ship, you'll need to find another way to seal the gap by either putting a series of airtight hangar doors in front of it, and you can only do a certain amount of distance with those. But that's really it. That's what rotors can do. So hopefully you found that useful with the little light rig. And that ends this tutorial for now. So I shall say, stay safe, have fun, take care, until the next one. Happy engineering. Bye.